Maybe we'll just wait for another 5-7 minutes and we'll start in some time, because this is just to tell you that there are teachers who are also in another webinar which is just going to end in another 5 minutes, so they requested specifically you know, to involve them also in the webinar. So we're going to start with that and just wait for another 5 minutes and we'll definitely start after that. In the meanwhile, if you people have any questions regarding the previous webinar, please, you're most welcome to ask. Like one ma'am just said that, you know, she was finding some difficulty in using the animator. But whatever is the Sangeeta ma'am, I think I'm audible. And you have to see the, if you've logged in from your you know, laptop, I would suggest if you could shift it to your mobile. And I hope you people are again carrying one more device with you, because as I just said, you know, we're going to just make it a little interactive so that you also know that the thing that we are talking about is, yeah, thank you so much, Monica ma'am. So the tool that
Hello,
we are.
Sarika ma'am. Yes, can you hear me, Sarika ma'am?
Yes, ma'am, very much.
Yeah, ma'am, just one query. When we use quizzes,
yes,
so the screen that is visible to us,
yeah,
there all the questions, they come on the screen at the same time. It is just not like Kahoot.
No, it is not.
They are
like
not
Kahoot.
Visible to.
They are not. No, that's the same. Screen is not visible to the children. Children receive it one at a time. Okay, and okay.
But they,
yes,
they go at their own pace.
They go at their own pace.
So we cannot time it. Can we time that quiz?
Yes, we can definitely time that quiz. The only problem with timing, I mean, we, first of all, we are supposed to share it. And as far as the timing is concerned, that is the area where, you know, the next step after free subscription comes. Okay.
Okay. So in free subscription, that means we can't time it.
Yeah, we can't time that. But then, as I said, right now it is a process where, you know, we are all first finding out which is a comfortable tool for all of us so that we can proceed accordingly. But then initially, yes, because it's again not a testing tool. For testing, I still feel that either Microsoft Teams or
yeah, you're right, it might not be good for formal testing, but otherwise it's an interesting tool. I found it interesting.
Absolutely.
Yeah. It because is. It gives all the details.
Absolutely.
It gives a detailed analysis. But I was wondering if I can time it. I mean, I can give them a time limit of 10 minutes or so or something like that.
Ma'am, definitely you can. It's just that, Vijay sir, I think you have shared the screen. Yeah.
Ma'am, can I also ask a question regarding quizzes only?
Yes, please.
Ma'am, actually, I made the quiz, but the problem I'm facing, like small children, like for classes 1 to 5, do they have to log in for performing the quiz?
No, not at all. That is what I said as the first thing. No children, none of the children are supposed to log in, because see, our first priority is whether,
yes,
you know, our children email addresses, are we supposed to share it, because we have to take the consent from our school authorities also. So
yes,
we don't have to. That is why I told, even the tool that I'm talking about today, it's rather more suitable for small children, maybe class 1 to class 5, because, you know, that, and none of the tools are spoken about. I told you about quizzes, I told you about mentor, today I'll talk about Kahoot also. So we're not going to have that, you know, the children are not supposed to, until unless we wish them to be part of, you know, the Google, they are part of the Google Classroom in case, and we wish them to share, until that time, they're not supposed to.
So only we'll send the link, and by clicking on the link, they will be able to play the quiz.
Yes, and you, with quizzes, you don't even have to send the link, as I said, it in Menti also, you don't have to send the link. Just the way we played, like in the previous webinar, you just have to show your screen to them. They'll go to quizzes.com/join, and there is a code that is written over there. A similar kind of concept is with Menti also, and a similar kind of concept is with this one also.
All right. Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am, Yes. Ma'am, in the quizzes, when is the code generated? Because I once I tried, there was a code, and the other time I pasted the link and the children could play. So I think it runs both ways, but I'm still so confused.
No, no, no. It runs both ways. Even Kahoot, what I'm talking about, I will show you both the ways. You can share the screen also with them. You can, just share the link also with them. As I said, these tools are not restricted. We are, just that, we are, since we are wanting them to play us, play the game live with us. That is why we are using certain options where, it is comfortable with them as well as for us. Because as I said, right now the tools, I am not telling you, too many details about it, because for that we have to purchase the subscription also. Right now the tools and the limited part that I'm telling you is with respect to just to have that fun element back into your classes.
Yeah, exactly. And that could bring in that part which you was always stressing about. No, that fun was there. Yeah. So at least they could, it was a breakthrough that from the mundane learning every day and performing it for the assessment, they really enjoyed it.
Yes.
Very nice, very nice. Because, that's feedback is something that is important for all of us. And yes, as I said, we teachers, we do understand the limitations, so we don't have to talk about the cost and all. Whatever free is given to us at specifically this COVID time, and whatever we can use to make our classroom interesting, I'm telling you that, and that's what is applicable to all the teachers, even all the students also can access, parents can access, in the sense that they can always have a fun element while they're together at home. So it's a good option. And today I'll just want to start with a nice game. If you have a mobile handy with you, or if you don't have a mobile handy with you, please just open another tab which is next to your laptop. Do that. Yes, yes, ma'am, I will be sharing the link of both the webinars. So what I'll do is, today's webinar is basically about three things. Okay, so because there are a lot of things that we could not finish in the last webinar, so we'll of course talk about another fun element to bring that interest back to our classes, and that is Kahoot. The other one is Padlet. Like a lot of teachers, they wanted to know about it, and it's a wonderful tool. I generally don't very easily maybe purchase or something, but I'll tell you all the features of Padlet, and you will, I'm sure, will definitely going to love this tool. And the third one is another animation kind of thing, for which I'll definitely going to show you a demo. So what we start is, we're going to start with the very first tool, which is called as Kahoot, but then we're not going to start just like that. We will first be playing an interactive game on this. Now, this game which I'm talking about, as I said, just like both the other tools, it also has an option of, sharing the link with the children and at the same time playing it. Okay, so I will going to tell you both the things. And simultaneously, but first we're going to play. See, the fun element right now in this case is, since I'm playing a classic tool, secondly, when I'm sharing the quiz with my children, I can always make sure that the question order is all random, the answer order is also random. At the same time, do I need your name? Yes, in case I feel that my class is a little naughty in terms of sharing the names with me on the screen, I can also have an option in this case of, can you see this friendly nickname generator? So the name is generated by Kahoot only. We don't have to, the child does not have to, write his or her name. So there are certain...
Sorry to interrupt you, ma'am. What is the team mode? Is it available free?
See, team mode, as I said, we can create, but limited teams is what we can create. Okay, and we're going to have a total of 100 participants, but I'll just come back to that also. So let's start with the classic mode, because I will only tell you certain things which we can use for free, absolutely. So let's start.
On laptop, can we install the Kahoot?
Yes, you don't have to install it. You all work online. There is no need to install any app. We do have an app on the mobile. You can download the app, or you can work live also. Okay, and Kahoot is nowadays coming up with some questions also. May I please request, in case your mic is on, if you are not speaking, can you just switch it off? Thank you so much. So as I said, we do have that option. And but before I talk about anything else, let's play with this. If you have a tab open, I'm going to start with this one. Okay, so it will just going to start.
Ma'am, somebody else has shared the screen.
Okay, is it my screen?
No, is there some Mr. Vijay?
Do we need to log in?
No, you don't have to log in anywhere. Mr. Vijay, could you please stop sharing your screen? Mr. Vijay?
Ma'am, can we have the pin?
Just a second, I'm showing it that to you.
Okay.
Hello, good evening, ma'am. Can we have a polite request of everybody who is not speaking to have this microphone off? It's causing a lot of background disturbance.
Yes, that's what I just said. Please have your microphone off. And Vijay sir, it's a request. Don't share your screen, otherwise teachers will not be able to see my screen. Please, okay, so I'm just showing you the screen and start with this. Just go to another tab, type www.kahoot.it. Were you able to log in?
No, ma'am, we did not see the pin. It just went.
All right. Can you repeat?
All
Can
right.
you repeat, ma'am?
Wait, please show the pin first.
I'll just restart it. I'll restart the quiz. Give me a minute. Okay, just a second. So I'm making this off. Now it will be in my control. So earlier it was in systems control. Okay. Please log in again. Go to kahoot.it and enter this game pin. If you have this app on your mobile, it's fine, it's fun. If you don't have it, nice. And we do have an option also in case, you know, when our children are playing the game with us and we feel that there is a name which is not appropriate, you put your cursor right over there, click, and you can remove that person also. I can see almost 120, 130 people in the main, so I...
Yeah, ma'am, can you tell how to remove the person? If
put your cursor right over there and click.
Okay.
Okay, can you
right
see click? That hand icon?
Ma'am, I had a question regarding this nickname part.
Yes.
Ma'am, suppose a child has put up an inappropriate name and we could find out and request the child or tell her to edit it. Is that possible, ma'am?
No. Because the name has to be given only in the beginning. So you can't.
Okay.
That's
ma'am.
Why you remove so the child and tell the child to re-enter it.
Re-enter. Okay. All right. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Because it's only immediately going to start. So it's a very fun kind of game, very simple. And
ma'am, is this music played by you or is this
music by Kahoot? And if you want to adjust the volume, see, can you see my screen on the right top right side? You can see I can reduce the volume.
Okay.
I can change the music. I can go to the music lobby. I can change the music. Now suppose if I want to change it from original to jungle, the music will change.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
You're welcome. So we have 75 people. I'm assuming at least 100.
Ma'am, kindly reduce the volume. You can't be heard. Thank you.
Is that fine?
Yeah, that's better, ma'am.
Can we start? Because I think there's a pause at 74 number one. So let's start. I'm starting the game.
Ma'am, is there any limitation to the participants' number in this quiz?
Not this one, but yes, a team one. But first you play, because you have time limitation in this game. You have to see my screen for the question. Now I'm playing. There is a YouTube video which I've included. Now here I have to increase the volume. I hope you've understood the question.
What is the question, ma'am?
The question was, which subject is emphasized in this song? There was this song, you know, this Madhuri Dixit song, Ek Do Teen. So, what subject was emphasized in this song?
Okay, we couldn't understand.
Yeah.
Excuse me, ma'am. There are two tabs on the screen that are hampering one of the answers.
Yes, you just see those four different color tabs. You
ma'am,
just
but in the questions, I have the questions open in the phone. There are two tabs open, I think, on your screen, which are I'm not able to see the second option there.
Ma'am,
please hide the tab.
Yeah, this
ma'am, please
what I'm
hide
saying.
The tab.
It is covering the answers.
This one,
ma'am.
Yes, one more is there.
Ma'am, the options which you are giving now, because that tab open, it is hiding.
Yeah, now it is gone. But then we did not attempt the first one because I was not able to see the answer.
Doesn't matter.
Okay.
Let's go on to the next.
Class is very interactive.
That's nice. The class has to be interactive.
Yes, ma'am.
So how do you get better at maths is what the question is asking you.
Ma'am, it's there on your screen. It's on mine. It's still classroom.
Not on your screen. You will only going to see the four colorful boxes.
Ma'am, but it's still saying classroom perfection and there's something going round and round.
So ma'am, then it has to be to do with the internet connection at your place. Like there are others,
okay, ma'am.
See that the others are able to.
Yeah, at my end also it is not working.
Excuse me.
As I said, because this game is happening live. Therefore, it all depends upon, you know, it's just a way to tell you how basically children will also going to interact when you are making a game in this. Okay?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, please.
Ma'am, I have a little doubt that if we are playing this game with our children, so do they have to switch on between my screen and their game screen?
So that is why I just said, first of all, children, if they're playing on mobile, it will be a little inconvenient for them because they don't know how to switch from one tab to another. But if I have to shift on my laptop from one tab to another, things are a little comfortable because see, it hardly takes even a second to shift from one tab to another. Like I'm seeing a question, if I just have to go to another tab, I just have to click and that's it. So it will not going to take much time with them. Nowadays, most of the children are already having mobile phones. So,
most of my students are taking these classes from the mobile and teaching these small kids is a bit tedious because most of the kids are from these games are mainly made for third, fourth, fifth class kids or
So I'll come back to the second option for this also, sir. So let's play first and I'll tell you how you can share the link also for the games.
Okay, thank you.
So the next question is, do you like maths? So today's quiz is just all about maths. And it also has points on the basis of how quickly you open the
So ma'am, is it something like this that you can trigger whenever you wish to put the question on the screen? Is it you
as a teacher, if I am playing live with you, it's completely up to me. I am controlling the quiz. Okay, and if you're sharing the link, then it becomes completely up to the child to start the quiz, but the deadline is given by us.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Yeah. So just like a scoreboard, we are having like in Menti we had a leaderboard. Here we are having a scoreboard, it's just to get that fun element in the class. You know, when they are playing some fun quizzes like this. Is a quiz same as a test?
Yeah.
a drawback in this. If a child's network is suffering, of course she's going to take more time to.
So that's one thing, ma'am. As I said, we have two options in this. One is playing live, and the other is sharing a link. So we can always share a link with the children. For which they don't have to log in from any login ID, but we don't get the response because the link code is from us. We are sharing.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay. So this is a.
Ma'am, can I ask you a question?
Ma'am, first attend the quiz, otherwise see the video.
Actually, question is not showing on my screen, that's why.
Ma'am, you are one of those unfortunate students whose network suffers during every class.
I'll answer your question, ma'am. Wait. So which, tell the symbol of neon in this video. And if you're not able to see my question, you must have pinned somebody else. So just unpin that and pin me, my screen.
On actually, ma'am, they have the same doubt. Actually, they will have to switch between the screens. So they are saying that they are not able to see the question. Actually,
if they are doing it with mobile, that's what I said. Like in the last webinar, I think a lot of people were not logging in from the mobile, they were using the laptop, so things were comfortable that way. So some of the teachers might not be knowing how to shift from one tab to another. So in that kind of situation, as I said, I will give you the second option also, and I'll let you know how you can share it, because you know different children have different queries with respect to working online. So I'll come back to this. Is this maths? Now there's a figure that you can see.
Sarika ma'am, the changing tabs itself, we spend a lot of time, no?
It's taking time.
We lose out on time.
So, this is the podium. Whoever came first, you will just be able to see. So, Miss Anshul third, and Miss Veena second, and apart from that, you're going to see the others. So, we can just have a report and all. So, you're going to see, and children are going to like all this. That's what I mean. When they see all this, they feel happy that you want to play the same quiz again. So, we do have an option of going on to the next quiz or the same quiz and all. So, I'll just come back to this part. I'm leaving this slide. Now I do appreciate.
Ma'am, how is the list of winners generated automatically after the end of the quiz?
Yeah, so I'll just tell you that. And now I'm coming to this also. Okay, the first thing is, let's come back to this particular part. See, I started with Kahoot. Kahoot is interactive way, just like Menti. In Kahoot, there are two things. First is, as a teacher, we have a control in terms of showing them the question. So basically, when this platform had come, they had this in mind that, you know, a teacher has a bigger screen to show and the children are playing live and they see the screen, see the question, start answering it instantly. So it came with this. And then now, obviously, you know, with the option of if the child is absent, the child is not there, then what am I supposed to do? Or like most of the teachers were saying that, what if ma'am, the child doesn't know how to shift from, one place to another, or having network issues. So in that case, we have an option with Kahoot, first thing. Second, Kahoot provides us an option of having an interactive quiz. And once you're interacting, with the children using the Kahoot quizzes, as I said, the colors will going to, the children will always be involved as far as the colors are concerned. When they see those bright colors and all, they feel nice. So when you go to kahoot.com, you're going to see a screen where you're supposed to, sign in for the very first time. So I have already logged in. So this is my account, Sarika Kaushal. To create a quiz, and as I said, I will not be going into too many technicalities because we are teachers from different subjects. Our task is to make our classroom interesting. So for making the classroom interesting, we want to just try certain things which we can implement into the class very, very comfortably. So we'll go to Kahoot first of all. So you log in, you go to Kahoot, and you will be having an option of creating a new quiz. Okay, so if you can see, create a new quiz. I have created a lot of other quizzes also for my classes. This is like computer science, and I play with them. First of all, the first advantage, if it's a live quiz, you don't have to tell your children to log in from their account. So one thing, so security wise, there are no issues. Second, we can create, it has a collaboration with the Google Classroom, but then, as I said, you have to take the permission. If you're taking permission from the authorities, you can go ahead with that, because then the authorities will see that, yeah, you know, this is a kind of feedback the teachers are giving, and, you know, this will be in long run beneficial for us. Third thing is, right now, teachers, students, everybody can just try and experiment with these tools, which are very, very interesting. Fourth is, I am sitting, and in another 10 minutes, I have a class. And I, at the same time, I just want to have a quick quiz to be created, just like Menti. So this also has an option. Go to create new, because a lot of us will not going to spend too much of time in making a quiz. If there is a quiz which is available, I will just going to have the quiz and I will start using it. Okay. So now wherever you see this orange color, this orange color, please make sure that for that you have to upgrade. So I'm only telling you with respect to the free account, the free subscription, which everybody can try. So I'm going to create this quiz, and you see this kind of screen. Now here we are only allowed to have two types of questions as of now. The first type of question is these simple, click the one with four options, and the other one is true and false. Okay, so the best part, which is not there in the other tools, quizzing tools, is that this gives you an option to have a YouTube video and a link for a video. So like the others, in the others you were allowed to have an image over there, but in Kahoot you can have a link of the YouTube video. Like in two of these questions, the Kahoot quiz that we just played, we had the YouTube link. So you can link at the same time. You can also say that you want to start a video from this time and you want to stop the video at this time. So if you've seen that neon video or even that ek do teen, I started from a particular clip and I stopped at a particular clip. Second, I just want to have a question quickly. So can you see this question bank right over there? Just click on the question bank and write down the question. Say I want to talk about planets, because today I think I just made something on planets, and which I'm going to show you. So this is the topic which I will just going to see. Just look at the question and keep on adding it. Name all the planets, so the planet is given. All planets have cores, so you are asking the question in terms of true and false. Do all planets have atmosphere, true and false? So whichever question you feel is appropriate for you, just keep on adding that question. Go over there, keep on adding the question, because once you're adding the question, things will be comfortable and easy for you. Which planets have rings and so on. So just like the other tools, here also you can quickly create the quiz and a very, very super fast way. Here you have options, like in Menti you were not. Why I'm comparing both the tools, different tools, so that you can understand and decide the best for yourself. In Menti, we had a restriction, because Menti is not just, can I please request someone's mic is on? Thank you so much. So in Menti, we had the option of taking the template, but then Menti is just not meant for only quizzes. It's meant for presentations and all. So there we had a restrictive, restriction in terms of the question banks. Quizzes is wonderful. Similarly, as I've shown you, Kahoot is more colorful. So children, small children, who are in classes 1 to class 5 or maybe 6, 7, 8, I have played that with my class 12th also. So believe me, they like this one also, because it's colorful kind of thing. So I close it. I already have 3 questions with me, and these questions are there. Okay. We do have an option in Menti.
Ma'am, just a little rewind back. Where was this question bank? And could you just show it again?
Yeah, definitely. I am going to the quiz. So can you see, I'm scrolling down, there is a question called add quiz. Under yes, that there is a question bank.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Now,
ma'am, is this a bank that you have created, or is this something that's already there?
Teachers everything has been done by teachers or whoever is part of Kahoot. Because, okay, one more thing. Good that you asked me this question. If you are working on the free thing with Kahoot and you have not taken the subscription, whatever you will going to create will be public. It will not be private. So you don't have the option of making it private and your own course. So that restriction, obviously, you can understand. You know, these apps, if they are giving us something for free, they want you to be their clients. And that is only possible when they keep certain things, important things with themselves. So as far as the question bank is concerned, whatever we create will be public. We can add a question from here. The question bank can be chosen. Now, suppose you have Excel sheet with you and you have a database already there. You can use an Excel sheet, but Kahoot recommends that you import the spreadsheet template, which I'll show you just now. So that's one thing. The second thing is, look at this question. Right now it does not have anything, but I don't want a slide either. So I go to the left side. Can you see this delete option? Just delete. So whatever you see on the screen is from where you have to select. It is as simple as that. So keep on adding, go to the question bank, get your questions, and if you're done, if you want to see the preview, you can go to the preview and see how your question bank will going to look like. So this is how your question will going to look like, how much time you want to give it. So this is my third question. If I want to go to my second question, this is my first question and all. And these are the number of seconds which are given. If you want to change those seconds with respect to every question, like this is my first slide, I feel that children should be given more time to this. So you can see up to 240 seconds a child can be given the time. So if I just want that 10 seconds are enough for this, for the performance, it's fine. If you don't want the marks to be visible, can you see the points? So in this case, just get the points right over there to zero. Otherwise, if you want to have 1,000, you can increase it to 2,000. So points are right over there. Time limit is right over there. And Kahoot is, it works very, very strictly with respect to the time. So you have question bank and start playing with the quiz. Now, if you're done with this, you're supposed to give the title to your quiz. So if I say planets, and if you want, it's an optional thing, description, just continue. So it is validating, it is making your quiz public. Now comes this one. So when you're testing this quiz, you can play now, and or you don't want to do that, you want to do editing, you can go back to edit. Otherwise, just go to done. Once you're done, you come back to your own screen.
Ma'am, one more question.
Yes, please.
When we are doing this Kahoot with our students, then we have to share our screen.
And obviously, that's what I said. Now, there are two options. I'm coming to that only, ma'am. Just give me one minute. Okay. So, first option is what I did with you people. You were playing the quiz live with me. So, when you click on play, I am clicking on play. I played live with you. So play a live game together with the learner over the video in a class. So if I've just taught a topic and I've already prepared a quiz and I want to just see how much my children have understood. So I am ready with my lesson plan. It's all done and I'm playing it instantly with them. Another is you can assign the quiz. Assignment is possible. Now here comes the answer for a lot of you who were asking that, ma'am, will they be able to see the question on their screen? Can I give them more time to perform? Can they play at their own pace? So yes. Click on assign, all right? So you can tell them that I want this challenge for the children, but please remember, here we have a restriction. Live quiz, we can have participants going up to in thousands. But as far as the challenge is concerned, we cannot go beyond 100. Can you see this? The player limit is 100. If you want to increase it beyond 100, you have to increase the, you have to upgrade. Okay, so there is a, if you want them to have a question in the randomized order, you say yes. If you don't want them to use their name or they just want to have a fun element, you want your children to have a fun element, let them have a nickname generator and all, the quiz will going to generate the nickname. Secondly, when do you want the challenge to get over? Because you will be sharing with, sharing the link with them instantly. So when do you want the challenge to get over? I want that today itself, today is Saturday. I want the challenge to get over by 7 p.m. Okay, so we still have 1 hour left with us. So I'm just giving and I'm assigning a challenge to them. When I'm assigning a challenge, we do have a link that has to be shared. It's just coming. Okay, so here we basically provide, this is something that you can copy. So invite more players, just copy this and share it with your students. You can copy, you can share it in the classroom, you can share it with the Microsoft account. As I said, it's up to you. You have to take the the permission from your authorities. So if you don't want to share directly into your classroom or Microsoft, you can share it directly to their email, or you can just post it in the class where they don't have to share their credentials. So security is also taken care of. It will be a free game to be played by everybody instantly, and at the same time at their own pace. So they will be able to see the question, and you can see that the challenge will going to end in 0 days, because we want the challenge to be played today itself, and it will going to get over by today itself. Okay, so I hope that part is clear to everybody. Now any question with respect to both the things?
Madam, excuse me, madam.
Yes, please.
Can we add our own questions for the higher grades, for the secondary grades? Can I add my own questions and then assign the challenge to them?
Definitely, ma'am. I just told you, I'm ending the challenge as right now. So I go to my quizzes.
And could you please share this link with us so we can have a look how it looks to us?
Yes, sir. I will be sharing everything with you. I'll share with you even my Padlet also, so that you can see what I'm working and how I'm working also. Just let me finish with the explanation. I'll share everything with you. So if you see this part, right?
I just want to ask one question. Yes. I have already created one Kahoot game, but what happened when I gave the students to do live questions to do, then that time their screen, they could not see the questions on their screen. Only the options were there.
Ma'am, that's what I said. When you're playing live with them, the question will going to come on your screen. Okay. They have to look at your screen. When you're presenting the screen, the question live, that's why I said Kahoot has two options. One is live play. In live playing of the game, they will have to look at your screen and they have to print, click on the option on their mobile. Okay, so they have to watch constantly your screen. Secondly, if the children are facing problem, switching from one tab to another tab, simultaneously, you can assign the game, just the second option which I just told you.
Yes, ma'am. Like right now, you are presenting the screen and your entire screen is visible. And yes. At the same time, if I want to see the children also, that those who are talking and asking, so can I do it simultaneously?
You can do that, but then I have to minimize. See, right now, when I want to see and I want to talk to you all, I have to open my Meet link like this.
Is there any option for simultaneous thing?
Yes,
like
ma'am.
Both the things. Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
So you have to divide your screen into two parts in that case. Two parts.
I'll show you.
Definitely.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
So as ma'am was asking, one of the teachers was asking that how to edit the quiz. So you can see this quiz I want to edit. I will go to edit, and once I'm in the edit option, I can just see. Ma'am, can you see this option of adding a question? Can you see this option of adding a question? Just add your question and increase the difficulty level. So if I keep adding a question, I will see. As I said, I just have two options. Can you see this orange color thing? So orange color is something which I'm not allowed to use because it's not under the free subscription. So you have two options of quiz and true and false. You can include a video. Suppose I would like to include a quiz in this case. Now the best part is I can include a YouTube link also. So I can have a link copied from the YouTube and I can paste it. And you can even tell. So for example, if I just show you that if I'm looking for... in YouTube, I'm looking for, say, a question on physics. I mean, I need to show some physics laws of Newton's law. Okay, so I'm looking for Newton's law. I'm sorry, my system has become, because of the live streaming, no, the system is a little slow. So I have mutants. So Newton's law of motion is there. I will just going to see one of the links that I have, and I'll right click it. I'll just copy the link address. I've copied the link address. I'll go back to Kahoot. I will go to YouTube link and I will paste the link. Okay, so the link is directly there. Now the best part is you can always tell which part of the video you would like to show. So go to the starting of the video. I want them to start from 1 minute and done. And from 1 minute, 20 seconds, for example, if you're doing it. So let's just have, so it's all set. 1 to 1:20 and just add a question. Okay, so it will automatically not going to start from the beginning. It will going to start from 1 minute itself. You can always see a demo and all, and it will be easy for you. So you just have these options. As I said, to create a quick quiz, just go to the question bank. To add your own quiz questions, go to the add questions, start adding the questions, done it. Once you are done, you can, the question we haven't given now. So we need to add the answers with respect to this, because obviously when we have given a question, we need all the four options also to be given. So I will going to again edit the quiz and just say those four options that I need to have in my quiz. And accordingly, I'll just save my quiz and two modes of playing my quiz. The first mode is, as I said, we're going to play live with our children, and the other option is playing it not live. So this got removed because I did not give these options of true, false, or the four options that we had. So if I just add a question, I'm going to have a quiz. I'm just going to have a YouTube link. I just paste the link and I'm going to add it. So here I'll talk about, just see whatever this is the option. I have 1, 2, 12. I'm sorry, I can't frame the question right now, so but I'll just tell you how it's working. So whichever is the correct answer, suppose my, on the basis of this question, okay, so which number is spoken in this video, okay, and suppose the answer is 56, so just click it. That's it. So can you see the other two options are not, or other three options are not? Suppose he's talking about two numbers. He's talking about 13 as well as 56. You can even have multiple options selected. So both, if the children, whoever is clicking on 13 will also be given points. Whoever is clicking on 56 will also be given points. If you
excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
But right answers you have to feed in prior.
Ma'am, they'll just press. Once they see those four colors now that you've seen on your mobile or your own screen, they just have to click on that. In free
No. Ma'am, right answer. How the system will know the right answer?
Ma'am, we have just clicked. Can you see this? Can you see this? Can you see
Yes,
this?
I can see.
So this is right. This is right is what we have put, but children will not see it. Children will only see if suppose clicking the green button, then his answer will be.
Fine.
Sarika ma'am,
yes please.
Sarika ma'am, as we go on framing the question, they will get saved automatically, or do we need to save it every time?
Automatically. Can you see at the top, save to my Kahoot? Everything you're working online. You people are working online, so that's the best part. Your system is not taking any memory and all. You're working online. You just need two things: your machine and the internet connection. That's it.
Ma'am, can I finish? In case I want to get back to my quiz, maybe after a week, I want to post it for some other section. Where do I locate my quiz? Because it has become now public. So where can I go back and locate it back?
They can locate it anywhere by just asking certain things. You know, they can just say a question on this. It's just that they will not be able to see your name or something. Okay. But then they can always, as I said, by default, if you are working on the free account, your quiz is public.
Yeah. I can't save it separately for myself that I can be using it sometime later.
No, the quiz is with you. The quiz is very much with you. As I said, if you look at this part, I'm just going. So I'm not fixing it. I am just keeping the changes. I'll just show you. So this, once your account gets open, all right, so you have, you can see your name. When you click on this name, you will going to see these quizzes which are created by you. So these are all quizzes which I played with my children and I have created it. Okay, and there are different ways of viewing this. This is this way of viewing the quiz. If you want to see a short way of quickly seeing the quiz, this is another way of viewing the quiz. If one of, suppose one quiz is one of my favorite quizzes, so I will just put a star. I mean, it's easy for me to find my favorite quizzes and all. You are allowed to have, you're not allowed to have a folder in this case, because you can see this orange thing. See, now these people are very smart. The smartness is actually in terms of, they say that, you know, it's free for teachers and you can use it on a 14-day trial and all that. But let me tell you, when I click and I go to upgrade now, okay, if I go to upgrade now, they first will going to ask me, before I say yes for the free trial, they will be asking me for, giving me my card credentials. So they say that you can start a free trial. And at the same time, they are not even charging me $6 per month. They will actually going to debit 72 dollars per year. So they are not taking monthly even fees. So it's just that what I'm trying to say is you can always go for the premium version, but first try and test it.
Yeah, exactly.
And you are comfortable. So they will definitely going to keep a lot of things with themselves. And that's why that's something that I thought I'm going to tell you. One more thing is there. In Kahoot, if you would like to see the reports and all, just go to this section of report. Okay, so whatever quizzes that you have played with your children, the database gets stored right over there. Okay, so you go to reports and you can always see what had been the feedback and, you know, how children, if they've actually entered their right name, you can download the quiz in the form of an Excel sheet also. Okay, so you have the quizzes, like 103 people had played this quiz. So you basically go to this option, you can download the report.
Ma'am, there's somebody else presenting, Anazia Ahmadi.
I do see. Can you please, Nazia ma'am, can you please stop presenting your screen? It will be very difficult otherwise. Okay, so I think now I'm back with my screen.
Ma'am, I want to know one thing.
Yes.
In quizzes, we have a lot of ready-made quizzes available.
Yes.
So is that there for Kahoot also?
Yes.
Because I was searching, I could not find anything related to English class 10th, like I teach English in class 10th. But in quizzes, there were many things that were already ready.
Ma'am, it all depends. You know, the thing is that it all depends upon which all teachers are using which particular app for what all purpose.
Okay,
so, as I said, this platform is generally used for those who are, maybe for small children, for bigger children also. But then quizzes looks little bit more mature, because I just told you when I was telling you about the options of quizzes. If you remember, I told you, you have the option of chemistry formulas and physics formulas and all those subscript and superscriptic option and all that. So when you have those options, the children, the teachers feel more comfortable, you know, going and working with that. So it all depends who's using them.
Thank you.
I'm just wanting more. If by any chance we mark the correct answer wrongly, can I undo it and do it again, or do I have to delete the question and go all the way along?
No, you are talking about as a teacher when you're doing it?
Yeah, as a teacher, when I'm creating the quiz.
When we mark a tick
correct answer. So can I undo the correct, if I
have... Absolutely.
I tried doing it again, means clicking it again on that, but then I have to delete this line.
No, ma'am, you don't have to delete anything. Just go to edit.
Yeah.
I'm just showing that to you. You're going to edit and you will just going to, let me just show you one of the questions. If this is the question.
Suppose instead of true, I want false now.
So just click over there. You are editing the question. And can you see so, it has been changed?
Okay, okay. So it will take only one answer, even out of MCQ.
Ma'am, see, as I said, with free subscription, one. With the four, see, between true and false, there can't be both the things possible. Na?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
With this one, with the quiz, there are multiple options possible, but the child can only select single. The child cannot select multiple because, again, you have to, can you see this orange symbol?
Okay, okay, okay. So thank you.
We can have that option, but children cannot.
But we can change the correct answer.
Yes.
Yeah, while creating the quiz. If I want Pluto, so I can change the answer to Pluto right now.
Yes, ma'am. Just click it over there. It is done.
But now we have got to.
So just click it again over there. Now it is not there.
Okay. Okay.
Thank you. Like in Google form, we are giving answers also so that children can be able to get the marks then and there only. So ma'am, is there any facility here?
Ma'am, the answer was already given. Did you see while you were playing?
Yes,
you
ma'am.
Played the quiz.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So when
yeah.
you had the correct answer or the wrong answer, it showed which one was correct. It was there.
Okay.
So I think this tool was pretty okay. So can you see? This is what we've already done.
Excuse me, I want to ask, ma'am. I want to ask a question. I'm Mukta.
Yeah.
Excuse me, ma'am. I had played quiz live quiz using Kahoot many times with my students, but like link sharing, I came to know for the first time, and thanks a lot for that. Now as we are using classrooms, Google Classrooms. So if I'll be posting link using Google Classroom, the students will be able to see the questions also. And yes, as you showed me the link, if I'll post and the reports or whosoever will play my quiz will come exactly in the same way as we get here.
Yes. Yes.
Like I have a class of 30 students and I'll be posting the link. I'm not playing online. I'm posting the link and the students are doing it with their own comfort.
Yes.
So ma'am, will the students, first thing, will the students, like each child will be able to see the correct answer, his or her own options like marks?
Yes,
and
ma'am.
Will I'll be getting the reports?
Ma'am, you will be getting the report because you have shared the link with certain students. Okay. If you're making it public, then also whoever is playing, you will going to get. Now, here comes a team concept. Somebody was asking me regarding the team. You can make a team. The restriction that we have is that you can have a team with some restricted number of members. But then why team is not right now recommended? Reason being because we have to upgrade our subscription. So the link sharing option is basically just a way right now where you are sharing a link with the student so that they can play the game at their own pace. You know, so that the difficulty when you are playing with them online, whatever difficulty that these people are, you know, they're facing, they should not face. Ultimately, what is our task as teachers? As teachers, our task is to make them learn in a very, very fun way. So this is like a tool that, you know, we can always go ahead with that. Can I go on to the next tool?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah.
The screen is not visible.
No, I'm just showing my screen. Now, is it visible? Okay. Now, simultaneously, just keep on seeing which is the background platform that I'm using. Initially, I use this platform where I started with the, you know, a nice music. Then, this is my first tool which I had just done with you. So that is Kahoot. Now I'm coming to Padlet. Now what is Padlet? Nowadays people are talking about a lot of virtual boards and all where, I play a game with my students. I have to log in somewhere. I create a presentation for my students. I store it in my drive. I create a video. I store it in my laptop. So I generally don't spend so much of time in organizing the stuff. So what I do is, Padlet is basically kind of virtual board which helps you to organize your data no matter where they are. They can be on a YouTube, they can be on your system, you can upload, you can link, you can connect, and at the same time, your output becomes interesting. It looks interesting. When I say it looks interesting, just give me 1 minute, because I think there are four people who probably they don't want to ask a question on YouTube because it's going live also, na? So, all right. So there were a lot of messages also. All right. Those who are watching online, I'm going to take your questions later on also, please. Because I will not be able to see it right now. Okay, so just see the background screen that we have. The screen looks a little interesting. First of all, anything which is colorful, children are always fascinated with that. So it's interesting. Secondly, can you see, I can just make it like this and I can move. And it's a normal platform where I'm not using any presentation, but at the same time, I can link my presentation. So what is a Padlet? A Padlet is nothing but it's an online virtual board. Just like, you know, when we have to remember something, we pin it on the board. So this way we have a Padlet that we have, created. You have to go to padlet.com directly and you are supposed to just start creating. You will going to see again the same option, signing in or logging in. So I have already logged in and this is my icon. I will just take you to this section. So how can you have again a fun element in the class, and not just fun, you can organize so many things in your Padlet. See, suppose I am a science teacher. Or I'm an English teacher, or I'm a Hindi teacher. So if I'm a Hindi teacher, and I'm an English teacher, or a science teacher, every day I'm taking in online classes with my children. When I'm taking in online class, I want that whoever is absent can at least see what I taught. Can at least go through the assignment, whatever I have shared, because I may not be able to remember whether I shared it with the student, these many number of students, or I've not shared it. So it is an interesting way. I'll first show it to you and then I'll come back to this Padlet, how you can actually go about. It has an interesting feature for, even the history teachers, where you have to see the map of all over the world and, you have to explain about a particular topic and all. So there's so many things which are possible. So first I'll give you an example and then I will explain you how this is working. Just see this play button, I'm playing it. And there is something which is played. So here we'll just talk about a few planets. I have already created a Padlet for this one. So since we are having a Padlet, we're just clicking over there and we'll see that these are different planets that we have. So I'm just pausing this. That means, first of all, Padlet gives me an option, not only for organizing the things, but at the same time for recording my screen. I can record my screen up to 5 minutes. I can record five minute lessons. Because see, ultimately when we are showing certain things to the children, ultimately we are sharing presentation with them. But at the same time, I am also, interacting. So I'm not speaking generally for more than 5 minutes. I can create clipping of five minutes and I can share it with my students also instantly. Second, I could have a link. Now I'll take you directly to the Science Padlet where I took a science class with my students. I mean, of course, I'm not a science teacher, but I just created this to show it to you all. So say it's my science lecture. I have to explain them about the different planets. So that's why I took the example of planet, because it was at the back of my mind. I loaded a video from the YouTube and I just played this video.
Making up 85% of its radius, while Earth's inner and outer core account for just 50%.
Because I wanted my children to see this video. Second, when I was talking about Venus, I want them to see how Venus looks like. So I say, see, it's the image in the enlarged form. Similarly, when you're talking about some other place or some other thing that you want them to see in the enlarged form, you can always include the image. Third is, can you see this something in red color? I did not make it in red color. These are all links. I have connected them with something. First thing I connected them is with the video on Venus. So there is another link which I did not find in the YouTube, but I found it as another source. So I linked it over there. And here I can talk about, the active volcanoes which have been seen on Venus. So there is a video which will automatically going to play right over there. And you can see, I can click on the play button and it is played. So the buffering is happening, as I said, because your YouTube is also going live. So
the new discoveries reported Monday show the planet is not a dormant world. It was long.
So for me, the things have become very convenient. I can join one part to another part. Secondly, suppose I created a presentation for my class. Since I have created a presentation for my class, I go to the presentation. It is there in my drive. It is there in my Google Drive. Can you see? My children can also access, if I want them to access, my presentation, and they can always see what is the presentation which I created for them. So they will going to click on the present button. They can see that this is what ma'am had sent me. She's taught this part in the class, and this is what. So I have connected my Google document with my Padlet. Third is, I can even embed a musical video. So I can have a video. That video is stored in the form of an MP4 in my Google Drive. It will automatically go into buffer. It will automatically. So children can see it at their own pace. So you don't have to. I converted the same thing into a video also. So they can see the video. So the whole idea for telling you all this is that children can see so many things at one place in one page, so they don't have to buffer. At the same time, they'll know that, yeah, ma'am taught this in the class and we have not missed anything. Secondly, to make further, you know, get interest in the class, see what I did with my class. I created a Padlet where, you know, I asked them question, the live question and the live answer is what I got. So if this is my class, they did not have to share their credentials with anybody. I did not ask them for any credentials. I gave them a question and I told them, please have the answer for this one. See, and I kept the complete control in my hand. For example, somebody had posted something. It's only me who will going to approve. If I don't find this content appropriate, I will going to delete the content. So I can see this is what they have done. I have only allowed them to include an image. This was my question. You can see Sarika Kaushal. This was my image. And I gave them the permission to include an image and the answer. So I have the complete control over what my children are sharing and what they are and where they are sharing. Okay. So this was just the hang of the whole thing. Now I'll tell you how do I do all these things in Padlet. You can see I have created 12 Padlets. You in the free account will only be allowed to create just 3 Padlets. But when you begin with 3 Padlets, I think that's good enough, because when you're starting with those 3 Padlets, they are, as I said, to begin with, let's learn, you know, how we work with that. And it's very, very interesting. And even it's not at all costly also. I mean, if you just want to purchase that in future, it will only going to cost you 1,000 rupees per year. It's not costly. It is, I spend that. I spend that only after trying and testing it, because I was very, very amazed with the features. I have tried Wacolet also. If you try to compare it, this has a better platform in terms of, allowing you to embed a lot of things and allowing you to share the information in a variety of ways. So now I'll tell you how to create a Padlet.
Excuse me, ma'am, in free subscription, is it 3 presentations per month, per annum, or only 3?
Ma'am, 3 for free, completely free. You can use it for as long as possible. I mean, if you just can go with these 3, you create one, delete another, recreate it. So 3 is something which is allowed completely in free. Okay.
3 at a time.
3 at a time. So okay. What I'll do is, okay. So I'll just create a demo Padlet with you. Can you see this Padlet icon on the top left side? So when you click on Padlet, you will be able to see these options: make a Padlet, join a Padlet, or there is a gallery. Now, gallery is the option where you will see a lot of other people who have already created the Padlet. So if you want to take some idea from them, you can take the idea. I took the idea of Planet's Padlet from here only. So I thought it will be interesting to tell you all that and to make you see all that. So I'll go back to the Padlet. I want to create a Padlet. Now let me create a Padlet and say I'm a history teacher. I would like to explain the history content with respect to the play. So I create a Padlet. So just say make a Padlet. Now these are the different Padlets formats that you can have. If I want to explain something to my children with respect to the map, like in geography or in history, this is the format I should go. If I'm an English teacher, and I want that I've given them a topic on discussion of a novel. Okay, so the back channel is something where you can communicate like a chat, but you can have a complete control as a teacher in your hand. If I want them to have little fun with their presentations, go for Canvas, if you have seen that. If I would like to, I'm an arts teacher, and I want to show the gallery of pictures, one after the other. I can go in the form of shelf, or I can go in the form of stream. My choice. So it all depends. What do you exactly want? If I want to go in the form of sequence, one after the other, I can go in the form of timeline, just the way I had shown you regarding the planets. Okay. So let me give you an example of map first. If I just select the rest of the Padlets, you all can try, and I will share this Padlet also with you all, so that you can open in your own machine and you can see. Now see. This is a Padlet that is created for me. I would like to, can you see it's written, my Radiant Padlet. Suppose I want to give it a name, my history lesson. So see on the right side and write my first history chapter. Okay, history chapter is there. So I have a history chapter made with Charisma something, which is a description. So you can see as a description, you can say chapter one. Icon, if you want to have an icon, like I had a smiley icon, if you want to have an icon, you can use that. Or otherwise, it has an option also. So suppose I would like to show an icon of, say, a tiger, I can click that. And once it's done, so you can even have your own icons and also. So once it's done, the icon is there. Can you see the tiger appears right that side? Now I can have a unique address for my Padlet. Why do I need a unique address? So that if I have to share it with somebody or I have to link it with another Padlet, I can do that. Next is, I don't like this background. Let me change the background. So let me change it to, because I've worked with this one, so I feel this is more appealing. So my background has been changed. Okay. Now comes a very interesting part. Because you will be working with this, you want, if somebody is trying to post something, you want to approve, then only the person should be able to post so that you can, you know, let the child work. So you have these credentials accordingly. Okay. Secondly, display the author name. Now, since I am the author, with every post that I'm putting, if I want to show my name, Sarika Kaushal, I can say, attribute, display author name above each post. So above each post, my name will be visible. Secondly, the comments. Do I allow comments in this? It's completely up to you. If you say yes or you say no, completely up to you. Second is, if you had seen that Padlet of 11G and this, can you see this thumbs up button and thumbs down button? Even in YouTube also, you see thumbs up and thumbs down. So the same thing is possible, right, using reaction. So there are different types of reactions. You can have a heart reaction, you can have a voting reaction, you can have a star reaction. So if I want to have a voting reaction, I'm going to see this one. Once you're done with your basic idea, just say next. Okay, and start posting. Now you're done with your Padlet. I want to first, my first topic that I want to teach in history is about Goa. So just go to plus, because this is about the map. So just say Goa. When you say Goa, it will automatically going to locate. Okay. Now this is Goa, somewhere within India. And let me just, don't write anything about Goa. Let me just have Goa. Okay. Now.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, for this Goa, from where you went?
I'm coming to that. I'll include one more space, place also, this kind of place. Just give me a second. Okay. So now this is a huge map. Can you see at the bottom? There is a plus sign and the minus sign. Zoom in and zoom out. So if you okay, so if you see the minus sign, you will be able to see India's map. Coming back to this. So as just ma'am asked, Can you see now? So in India, Goa is somewhere here. If you further want to zoom, you can see this is Goa. All right. Now I want to include one more place. Let me. So ma'am, did you see what did I do? I had gone to this plus sign. I clicked and I wrote the name. Suppose my second place is New Delhi. Okay, it will automatically come. I don't have to do anything. Click on New Delhi. It will automatically going to come. It will find a place. And can you see New Delhi has come? So right now, when you show it to your students, this is what is shown to the students. I'll just reduce the size and I'll shift my screen. Can you see? I'll shift my screen and I'm just increasing a little bit of size. So I'll shift it to this one. You just have to scroll your mouse and shift the screen. The moment you put a cursor here and click, you will see Goa. And with your name, Sarika Kaushal, because you have mentioned that. Similarly, when you click, you will see your name again. Now, what do I want? I am teaching in the class. I want to write, tell them something about Goa. Okay? So when you click on this Goa, the moment you put your cursor right over there, can you see this pencil icon? And you can see these three dots. Why do I have these three dots? So that you can make your post colorful. First thing is make your post colorful. So it will come in blue color. Let me see what else can I do with this one. I can change the location. I can transfer the post. I can do so many things in this case. Okay.
So as you can type the Himalayan range also. Yes, you can come show me the range also.
Yes, ma'am. You can see that also. So if I say Himalayan.
Karakoram range.
Karakoram.
Or Himalaya range, whatever is
Para. This one? Karakoram. K A R A K U R A M. Karakoram Pass. Is that all right? Or highway or Karakoram?
Karakoram range, ma'am.
So can you see it has come somewhere at this place? Can you see this part? See, it's. Let me enlarge this. Let me enlarge this. Can you see this? So I don't know whether geographically if it's correct or not.
Yes.
It's correct. Beautiful.
It's correct.
So, okay. So now if I suppose, okay, I need to talk about Karakoram. So I click here, click on this icon, right? As I said, go to these three. So right now, just don't go to these three. Go to the edit pen. Just go to edit. I'll only go in, will be in a position to tell you. See, it's already 6:13. So I'll just tell you about a few options. And I'm sure you'll love it and you'll be able to do it yourself. See, can you see the first option? It says upload, drag a file. The second option says you can link, provide a link, a hyperlink. The third is you can search for an image. So if I click on Google, for example, and I'm looking for an image, okay, and I'm looking for Karakoram, so whatever is a name, it will automatically search for this one. I click on this and see it is linked. How nice it is. So if I click on this picture, it will show me the enlarged form of the Karakoram mountain. Similarly,
wonderful, ma'am. It's wonderful.
Yeah.
Secondly, it's wonderful.
Something very beautiful.
Yeah, ma'am. So thanks a lot. Thank a big thank you for you.
You're welcome. Secondly, if you want to include and you want to connect your content with your slideshow, suppose you have a slideshow also. So if I click on the pencil icon, okay, just make the editing part. Suppose it's Karakoram video. All right. Now I will go to my drive. Let me go to my drive and let me open. I'm going to my drive and inside my drive, there is suppose a folder. Suppose there is a presentation which I've created, as I told you. The buffering is becoming a little slow in this case because, as I said, YouTube is also going on simultaneously. Okay, so see, this is what I created. I just click. So I made certain things for you. Let me just right click on this. Let me just copy the link. What I'm trying to tell you is that I can always link it with the So get a shareable link. And of course, it will going to ask me for all the privileges. Okay, so whoever I would just change these privileges. And once the link is done, I'll go back to Karakoram. And over there, can you see this? Just select it. Once you select, can you see this lock? Click over there and paste the link. That's it. So once you click, when I click on this link, see, can you see the cursor has changed to a hand indicating that it is a link. When I click here, directly my presentation will going to open. So this way I can connect one part of my document. So it all depends upon creativity, your creativity. It all depends upon what kind of element that you want to have show to your students, how you want to make your classroom more interesting. So just get that stuff your own self and just try and experiment. That's one of the things. The second is, if I edit this further and I don't want to show the image, let me go and show a YouTube video. So can you see these three dots? Just see these options. They are wonderful options. Upload. You can upload the file from your computer. You can link. You can go to Google search. You can snap. You can film. So this way, you can just go to the URL. You can go to URL and say, in the meanwhile, if you already have a video, you can always link the the URL of the video also. It will be linked directly over there. So when I say this one, this is again a document. So I can just save it. It will going to find, and it's all connected. It's all connected with it. So it's all connected, you can see. And secondly, one more thing is there. So as I said, you can add, you can upload your document. Everything is organized so beautifully at one place that, you know, when your children will be able to see, they'll see, wow, ma'am, we did not have to go to different places to search for it. Neither will you have to go in future. So next is, what else can I do? I can connect this Padlet with another option. So if I just show you this, can you see the last option called as Padlet? If I want to connect it to the Padlet, I can connect it to any of these Padlets. Suppose I would like to connect this to Planets. So this Karakoram is now connected to the Planets Padlet. If you have seen, when I clicked on this part, it opened the Padlet screen for me. So I was able to connect one Padlet with another Padlet in this particular manner. So when I'm able to connect Padlets, this is how I'm supposed to do. I'm just closing these options so that it doesn't create a problem for me in terms of buffering. Okay, so you can see this. So how I've used Padlet, in terms of connecting one part of my document to another. I've used Padlet for linking it with another Padlet. I have used this Padlet for having a hyperlink where I can connect one section of my document to another section of the document, and I can use it depending upon my own convenience. Secondly, I can use it to get I've given a task to my children and I want to make a wall of fame. So wall of fame kind of thing, I can always appreciate my children and I can say, okay, on the basis of what you people have done, these answers, I will going to give you an appreciation. How do you give the appreciation? Just go to this kind of wall, just go to plus, add. Can you see this Sarika is there? I can just search and I can search for, say, smiley as an image. Once it's searching for a smiley, I'll get the smiley. Let me get this smiley and I can write a title. So I say wonderful. Say the name is Nidhi. So I have given a wall of fame for them and they will feel happy. There's something which is always there with them, with me, and people will also appreciate this. So now how am I supposed to share this with anybody is another important thing. Suppose I would like to share this with you people. Okay, can you see this share button? Click on the share button. Initially, there are some privileges which you can give to the people. I can always change the privacy settings. Now, just the way you can have members in the other online tool, same way you can have members in this also. You can always add your members if it's in a closed group. If you want your children can, I mean, if you're allowed that your children can use their official credentials, you can always add them. If you don't want them, you can just share a link. But before sharing a link, always change the privacy settings. Click on this. I want that teachers right now, whoever is able to see my Padlet can see this. But I have given a password and the password is Planet. I have told you publicly that the password is Planet. You are not allowed to change this, but you can always read it. You can read the Padlet. You can write on the Padlet. You can change my Padlet. I don't want you to change my Padlet. I just want you to see my Padlet. So I will just going to share. Therefore, what I'll do is, I'll copy the link to the clipboard. So when I copy the link to the clipboard, the link has been copied. I'll go to Meet and I'll go to the message. Okay. So when I'm going to the message, I will just going to paste it. I'm just pasting the link and enter. Now you all can see my Padlet. You all, if you try using some other device or you're clicking on your machine in another tab, you all can see my Padlet. You can see this. This way you can share it with your students also. So once you're sharing it with your students, they'll love it. They'll like it because that's what they want. They want interaction happening in the class. So when you're interacting with them like this, they will be very, very enthusiastic to learn. Okay. So, I don't
know. But ma'am, we need to enter the password. It is asking for Planet. The password.
So I told you, na, the password is Planet.
Okay.
Because see, I have given the credentials accordingly. Planets, P-L-A-N-E-T-S. So the password is Planets. And you all can see. Whoever has that password, you will be able to see now. This one.
And later, ma'am, one question. So how we can share this Padlet? How we can show the Padlet when we are conducting the classes? So with the share screen, you know.
Yeah. I'm sharing it only with you. See, I've opened the Padlet. I'm sharing it with you directly. I have not created any presentation. You can see I have not created any presentation. I'm just live
showing. The password is
just like the web pages.
Planet, ma'am. The password is Planet. P-L-A-N-T-S.
And it's in small letters, no?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Somebody was asking some question.
So in other words, it is the web pages designing.
Yes.
In short.
Ma'am.
Creating web pages, like.
Yes, please.
Ma'am, can you once more show me how to share the link, please? I did not get it.
Okay. So when I want to share, suppose I would like to share this Padlet with you people. I'll go to share. Can you see at the top?
Yes, madam. Okay.
Just
got
click,
it.
Click on share and you can change the, but before sharing, I would always recommend change the privacy settings. Okay. You don't want children to write anything. You don't want, or if you want children to write, you also have an authority to control that. Secondly, you can also share your Padlet using the QR code. If I just click on the QR code, those who have a scanner can quickly scan this QR code, which is on the screen, and you can always see it. Okay, so it has the option. You can mail it. You can share it on Facebook. You can make it public by sharing it on Twitter. I'm telling you, you will going to like it very much once you start, enjoying attaching one document with another document, because once you start doing that, you will get involved more into this. So once you have more involvement, obviously, and as I said, it is not expensive. It is approximately 95 rupees per month, but just take an yearly subscription of around 1000 rupees. It's pretty good. I have done it. I have used it. And with my experience, I'm not saying this because I'm a computer science teacher. I'm saying it because if you've seen, I've taken examples of other subjects also. I've never taken an example of computer science because I do understand the limitations and the restrictions. So once your children are going to see, they'll be amazed with, you people getting so very much close to the technology. So can I go on to the third?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, please.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Ma'am, I am using Kahoot since last 1 month, and it is very innovative way, and students are inspiring by this, and they are very curious to attend the classes. So it has changed the way of the classes, first of all. And ma'am, this I want to know that it is paid, because last time when I tried to sign in and I was able to sign it, I created my Kahoot. When I went for paying it, it was asking that billing section, and in which, जैसे आपने भी बताया था कि 1 month का दिखा रहे थे, उसके बाद they were showing for 1 year. So should we go ahead for this?
No, I'll tell you, ma'am. देखिए, first of all, you should be comfortable with the platform. Secondly, if you are using your as a teacher, if you are just using your official account, you are a K-12 teacher, then you can play as many number of quizzes as you want, simple quizzes.
Okay.
Secondly,
then why are people asking for billing? I just I think put thing for the premium second number. I think $6.
Yes, but they're not charging you $6, as I told you. They will only charge you for an yearly subscription. So if you are ready to pay, you can go ahead with that. There are teachers who have been very, very happy. I'm not saying that you should not go. What I'm saying is you should go, but you must first try it yourself. If you are comfortable, please go ahead. These tools are there for us only to make our classroom really interesting.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you very much.
Neva ma'am was asking something. Can we create a Padlet one day before and share the link while teaching? Yes, ma'am, you can always do that. Always. You can create the Padlet. You can even create it right in front of them. And once it's done online, you can share the Padlet instantly also with them. But I'm again repeating, please be very careful in terms of changing the credentials, the privileges, so that children are not, they can only view. They should be the spectator. They should not be allowed to make any changes, because ultimately children are children. So we don't know sometimes if they are maybe not doing it intentionally, but could be a possibility that, you know, they can change. Okay, so that's there. And can we put a time limit if the children are posting their ideas in Padlet? No, ma'am, there's no time limit. You can stop them. You have it in your hand. So what you do is, you do have it in your hand. How do you do that? Just go back to share again, and you can stop. Go change the privacy settings and just stop them. They will not be allowed to open your Padlet. And the last quick tool I'm going to tell you. So I think some sir, Mr. Gaurav Kalia, was asking for the feedback form. Sir, I'm just going to share it. But I thought, let me just quickly tell, because the target for today was this one also. See, My Simple Show is something. But before I show you My Simple Show, just see this video.
We will learn about another animation tool. In the current scenario where we all are bound to do everything online, we should be willing to accept every challenge with open arms. Believe me, technology is not a challenge. It is fun. We will learn about a few more tools to make our online classroom more interactive and superbly amazing. So what should be our approach? Willingness to learn and ready to experiment and implement. And what do we need? Just a computer and internet connection. We must start making short-term goal and trying, testing, and finally implementing the tools which we will going to learn today. This will make us more confident and further prepared for future challenges. By maintaining our vision and strategy when going after our targets, we'll be successful today and in the future. So our goal is to learn and give our best.
So if you've seen this video, this was again made in just 5 minutes. And this is a platform where, you know, you can create a video with animated tools. And at the same time, this is more interactive, basically, when you're introducing a topic to your class. Suppose in biology, you want to introduce a topic. Suppose in mathematics, you are introducing a topic. Now, someone must be, feeling a little amazed. How can I introduce a topic like this in mathematics? I created a small video on that. And if I want to calculate a simple interest, okay, and I've not made a video, is I was just editing that, so I can just show you how it will going to work with maths teachers. This is the best animated tool when you're starting with the introduction. As I said, you're introducing a topic. So I'll just close this. I'll play my video and just see how I'm explaining simple interest in maths. It's just coming. Buffering is taking a little time because it's all online, as I said. This is an excellent tool for...
We will learn to calculate simple interest. Meet Ravi. He had to purchase a house at a principal amount of one lakh. He got a loan at an interest rate of 10% per annum for 20 years. How will you calculate simple interest? Regarding percentages, particular part of 100, 10% is 10 parts of 100, 50% is 50 parts of 100, 75% is 75 parts of 100, and so on. The formula for simple interest is as SI equals PRT slash 100. P is the principal, R is the rate of interest per annum, T is the time period. SI equals 100,000 times 10 times 20 slash 100. Hence the simple interest calculated.
So I was just trying to say that, you know, visual representation is always retained in child's mind. And how do we do that? It's very simple. I will not take much time to tell you about this part because I can very well understand that there's a limitation and restriction in terms of, it's already 6:32. Just give me 5 minutes and I'll tell you. Just go to mysimpleshow.com and log in. It allows you to create as many number of videos, free videos, but yes, with restriction of the animation that you can see. So if you want to experiment more with the animation, with the soundtracks, with the background person who's speaking, if you want to change it to a female voice, then you have to purchase it. Otherwise, start working freely. Just create a video. The best part is you can create a video directly from your PowerPoint file. If you have a PPT file, I'm not talking about Google. I'm talking about PPT. It accepts PPT. So you take a PPT file if you have a PPT. Suppose I would like to create a demo in English and I want to write my own script. I don't have a PPT file. So it will going to help you with a lot of options. Are you creating this presentation for professional purpose? Then choose one of the templates. Are you creating it for personal purpose? Choose these templates. Now, I am creating it for educational purpose. And I want to explain a historical event. Or I want to explain some medical disease. Or I want to explain some biological process. Or I want to talk about, say, if English teachers would like to interpret a literature or a movie. Or to summarize a famous person's biography. So if I click over there, the template is given right in front of me. So I have a template. They have given the example. They've given the example of Leonardo da Vinci. You can give the example of Mahatma Gandhi. Now, how nicely when, see, you, we all are explaining to the classes when we are speaking. We always explain while speaking. You just have to jot down those points on a paper or write it over there. It will going to have the visualized effects on its own. So if I'm just talking about, say, Mahatma Gandhi, and I just say father of nation. So it's basically script that you're writing. His background information is he was from India and he helped in getting freedom and he is father of the nation. So I am just giving you an example. Choose the visuals. When you're choosing the visuals, it will going to choose it on its own, which you can change, but we have restriction. So we have restriction, we have limitation in terms of choosing the visuals is what we are. So it has taken the interpretation of this Mahatma Gandhi like this. If you want to have an upload of the video, you can always, I mean, if you have Mahatma Gandhi picture, click on this, okay? And you can upload it. So you can upload. Again, the changes are saved directly, okay? So Mahatma Gandhi, whatever, it will show you X options and you can choose your options. It will tell you how many illustrations depending upon the words that you still have free with you. Choose them and start using them. Choose them. So you have five more, but then Father of Nation just had three words. So it has chosen best possible. If you want to choose something else in terms of Father, you want to have something like this, it is different. Similarly in this case, similarly in this case. So once you have done, you can just play a video and see how does it look like. And it will automatically going to interpret the writing part that you have done. So you just have to be a nice script writer for your own
Mahatma
writing.
Gandhi, Father of Nation. He was from India.
You can include the picture.
He helped in getting freedom. He is Father of the Nation.
Okay. So I think I'm not going to go beyond this because otherwise a lot of you will going to, you know, crib because I think I've already taken a lot of extra time in terms of...
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, please.
Ma'am, as you shows that presentation, can we set the timing of each slide according to us or it's prefixed only?
It's prefixed. A lot of things are prefixed as far as this is concerned because the free versions, they always give us a lot of things with restrictions. So that's what we have to remember. We can't prefix it. We can reduce the number of slides.
Okay.
We can remove, we can delete, we can remove the number of slides. What I'll do is, with more options, I'm going to share this through, and I'll be sharing the video of this, how you can, you know, use more features of this particular tool. And I will be forwarding the link also to you so that you can just have a link and you can start making your own videos. But as I said, you just write a script for yourself, start working. It is very, very simple. I've just done it in front of you. Did I take much time? I did not take much time.
Ma'am, I want to ask a question. May I?
Yes, please.
Actually, I'm all new to this Google Meet and all. I'm teaching for the first time online, like many others also. So is there any tutorial video or link for these kind of apps? Like it is a wonderful session. I had it for the first time. So I want to have a tutorial.
See, if you, for this video, I will be sharing the link. As I said, if you want to learn more on these tools, you can go to YouTube and you can share. If you want me to share the links, I will further share it with you. So there are lots of options. YouTube have anything and everything which is there. Okay. So
can we have your mail ID so that if any help requires so that I can mail you or...
Definitely, ma'am. I shared the also. You will not be given the e-certificate till you fill the feedback. Okay, as far as my mail ID is concerned, email me at csbhasha@gmail.com. I told you that I have.
Okay, it is. I think it is given in the mail, which is I got as an invitation, right?
Yes.
Okay, thank you so much.
Anytime, ma'am. So you can always mail me. As I said, I will try to be as prompt as possible and I'll come up with more. And in the meanwhile, while you people are, you know, filling up this form, can I show you one more thing while you people are filling up the form?
Yes, ma'am. Why not?
Yeah, I'll just show this to you because a lot of requests had come regarding this, which I can always continue with my next webinar. See this.
augmented reality, great.
Yes, because you know nowadays the videos are very much there, and you know people are talking about this term, augmented reality and all. And teachers feel that, oh my God, I think it must be very, very tough and too technical. Yes, it is technical to a certain extent, but then, yes, we're going to have, I'll take the next webinar on augmented reality, specifically only one topic, so that we teachers can implement whatever is possible, you know, within our range to our children. And as I said, augmented reality is something which is new for India. It's otherwise not new. But then its softwares are very, very expensive. So we don't want to pay so much initially. I'll tell you, I'll bring with a free tool, which you can download as an app on your mobile, and you can start working on this. So I'll tell you that in my next webinar, which will be, you know, coming up. So something which is little, you know, I'm sure you're going to look forward to this.
Sarika ma'am, sorry, I'm taking you back again to one simple question.
Yes.
Regarding that animation thing you talked about, no, My Simple Show. Yes. You talked about that this is a simple version. So where does this simple end? Like the free version, where does this free version end? How brief should we be to access the free version?
Okay, ma'am, I'll tell you. See, first of all, there is no restriction in terms of the number of slides. Okay. Secondly, don't download the video, just finalize the video, because one download is only allowed, and after that it will, even in pro and the other version, it will going to ask you to pay. So I have not downloaded anything. If you have seen my video which I played, it was online. This part is online. I haven't downloaded this. So what you do is just finalize till the end, and it will be on in your account only, always available. So when you are going to this section, I am using a free account. I have created already 3-4 videos, and one I just created right in front of you. So you can have a number of slides. The only problem is per slide you will going to have limited number of illustrations. Those pictures that you see, six illustrations are there. If you want to have more illustrations, you are supposed to you can upload it. I mean, if you don't want to use systems illustration, my simple show illustration, but you want to upload an image, it allows you. But per slide, I think 6, not more than that. And you cannot change the voice. You cannot change the hand movement, whatever has been shown in the video. So like I just got this metamorphic rock also, just to show. So I am just trying to tell you that, you know, we have limited or restrictive things, but they are nice.
That's fine with beginners. We are beginners, so that's fine with us. I think that that also is too much to use.
So ma'am, it's beginning for me also. I mean, I'm also learning along with that, because these are tools which are really, really amazing. Because see, we teachers, we need something which we can create very quickly in a very simple manner and present it instantly to our students. So with these tools, as I said,
Sarika ma'am,
yes please ma'am,
having a problem with the feedback. It's saying to fill out your form, you must be signed in. Your identity will remain anonymous, but I am signed in. I was one of the first people to sign into your webinar. What do I do?
I think
I'll send them to CS Bhasha.
Yeah, yeah. I think.
Can I answer this?
Please do that, ma'am.
Ma'am, I think you need to sign into your Google account. So on whatever system you are, so whatever your Gmail is, you need to sign into that. Am I right, Sarika ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. You are. Thank you. Absolutely. Because sometimes when we open the other tab or the incognito window, we are not signed in. You have to first log in so that you can fill, because there is a first option in the Google, this form that says that we will be taking your emails. Because, you know, ultimately we are sending you the e-certificates. Now, this time, a lot of teachers, they send us a mail saying that they were not able to, you know, they did not get the Google Meet link. The reason being because the email that they had sent wasn't correct. So just take some time, fill it properly, and you'll receive the feedback.
Excuse me, ma'am. Kindly tell me about tomorrow's link.
Will you share the link tomorrow also?
Yes, yes. We're going to share it on the mail.
Yes, ma'am. Thanks a lot.
We'll do that.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Can we have some class on the Google Classrooms also if possible tomorrow? 10 minutes.
All right, sir. We can plan. It all depends how much time we take. Google Classroom is not
tough. Use Google Classrooms in that way.
Yeah, we can use it. Oh, sir,
we can add Jamboard also.
Ma'am, we can do that. But let me tell you, whether you're using whiteboard or you're using Jamboard or you're using Openboard, you must have a stylus. And I would like to recommend this to specifically the math teachers, the science teachers. Please buy a stylus, which is, I'll tell you the name. It's on Amazon. It is called as Wacom, W-A-C-O-M. It's a Japanese company. It is wonderful. I mean, why I'm saying stylus, because whether you use any kind of board, online board, we will not be able to write it properly on that. So even
can you please repeat? Can you please repeat?
It is Wacom, W-A-C-O-M. I'm just posting that. And this Wacom is around 3,700. It is coming with some off also. So this much I think we all can spend, because you know ultimately our aim is to make our classes interesting, and this is right now the need of the hour. And we are not able to use Jamboard properly. We are not able to use Openboard properly. We are not able to use whiteboards properly, because we are not able to write with the mouse until unless we are having a touch screen. And we are not having touch screen. I don't have a touch screen. So you can go to Amazon. You can just search for Wacom. It's wonderful. And then, yes, we can have a Jamboard session. We also have another. Openboard is excellent. And Jamboard is, of course, free. Openboard is also free. And Google, sir, as you had asked for the Google thing, we can plan it. But it all depends how much time will Meenu ma'am take to finish, because you know tomorrow's session has already been pre-planned accordingly. If you are able to finish with the thing on time, we can always have the session.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Can I ask a question?
Ma'am, one minute, please.
Sure.
Ma'am, like in Kahoot, there are many ready-made quizzes are available. So yes, it's all public. So yes. Same like that, is it available in My Simple video also? My Simple?
No.
There? Ready-mades are available?
No, the templates are available, not ready-mades.
Okay.
So templates are good enough, because as I said, with the quizzes, with Kahoot, the quizzes are there with respect to the subject. Here it's an animation. I am describing something in my own way. Some other person may be describing the thing in some other own way, in his way or her way.
Okay.
So here it's a template which is given, where you just replace it with your own content and it's done.
And ma'am, one more thing. In Kahoot, one minute, ma'am. In Kahoot, like many quizzes are there, and it's really wonderful. Many ready-made quizzes are there. And the same is there, if we take a paid version, is it slides are also there? PPT is also available?
Yes, ma'am. If you're taking a paid version, you are even allowed to, create a presentation.
Hello. Not create, ma'am. Is there ready-made available, ma'am? Ready-made available presentation. Hello. Like quizzes are available?
Yes, ma'am. As I said, whether you are creating or not, you're using or not, the templates will definitely be there, because when we are paying for something, they always provide you. I have not used it myself because I'm still working on the free version.
Okay, ma'am. Hello. Okay, thank you, ma'am.
I've read it, but yes, they are providing these things along with the paid version.
Can we put our voice?
Yes, ma'am.
Hello, ma'am.
But not in the free version. Okay.
Hello, ma'am.
Not. Yes, please.
Ma'am, what about the feedback form? How do we have to fill up actually?
Sir, I've already